Hey guys, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new on here, my name is Tonya and you are totally and completely free to smash the subscribe button, break it, destroy it and do whatever you like with it, okay? In today's video, we are going to be telling you guys what we miss most about living in Nigeria. I know you're like,
me? Is there some kind of ghost?
No, you guys, in today's video I am collaborating with Dr. Zidam's vlog. If you haven't watched her before, she is a food and a lifestyle vlogger. She is a med student, if I'm not mistaken, based in Belarus, and we thought this was going to be a super fun video to make because we've both been living abroad for a while now and we're both Nigerian YouTubers, and we just wanted to share like our own perspective on basically what we miss about living in Nigeria.
What? Better don't call me and start lying that you miss Nigeria, because I remember very well you. All you wanted to do was live. You were doing everything in your power to live. Don't lie here. Don't be a liar. Okay, let's even hear it. What is it that you miss so much about the Nigeria?
Okay, so some of you will be like, yeah, Tonya, just lie. Let me tell you guys something. No matter how, no matter what you say, yeah, it's not the same thing. There are just some things about where you come from and where you currently live that are completely different. So yeah, if you're interested, just keep watching. First of all, I spent almost 26 years of my life in Nigeria, so my taste buds are used to eating Nigerian food. I would just be scrolling through Instagram, trying to be sexy and stuff, and trying to be an Instagrammer, and I would just see all this Nigerian food, you guys, the jollof rice, all the, you know, the peri-peris, the medemedes, you know, all those things. Gosh, I miss Nigerian food so much. I know that some people living abroad can't even tell the difference, but I can, because the food here is not the same as the food in Nigeria. There are African markets here where you can go to and buy African food stuff and make it, but they're not the same thing. For example, if you want to buy ugu, you need to buy the dry type that has been shipped from Nigeria or from Ghana or something like that. While in Nigeria, you can just buy a fresh ugu. Okay, here we have to substitute ugu for things like spinach. It doesn't have the same taste, it doesn't have the same feel, it's not the same thing. Okay, so I know that you guys will say, what's so special about Nigerian food here? Everything here is just cheese, fat. Hence the reason why your girl is just getting big every day. Another very thing in my face about Nigeria that I miss so much is like accessibility to things, to little things. Say for example, if the button in my shirt was to, you know, decide to give up on me today, I can just walk into an Obioma store or all those, I think they are called Obioma, they carry these sewing machines on their head and you walk around. You can just call them and be like, oh, my shirt is torn, you can pay 50 naira and they will fix it for you. Say for example, your shoe, maybe you know, maybe something cuts on there or anything goes bad on there, you have these shoemakers that you can just call and they will fix your shoes for you. Here it's not like that. Okay, if your shoe cuts, that's the end. Okay, you know, they give anybody, nobody's fixing it for you. In case you don't understand Hausa, that it has spoiled in Hausa. Okay, you're going to either A, learn how to fix it yourself, or B, throw it away. And then let's talk about, like, you know, for example, my hair. Say I have braids on and I want the braids taken out. I can just walk into a salon and be like, I want to take my braids out, 500 naira. Two girls would literally put their hands on your hair and make sure that in 30 minutes they're done. Here, you have to sit down for hours and hours taking down your own braids. That's the little accessibilities, you know, all those small things that you can just access that are not accessible here. Another thing that is so weird that I feel like I miss so much about Nigeria is being able to bargain things. For example, don't crucify me, okay? Don't call me cheap. For example, I walk into, say, Zara. All the prices are already fixed, so you have no choice but to buy them. But in Nigeria, you can bargain for things. You can go into a store and be like, how much is this thing? They'll tell you 5,000 naira.
It's only 3,500 naira.
She'll say,
no, now, bring 4,500.
I miss all those little, you know, bargaining things. And before you know, something that was told, that you were told is 5,000 naira, you end up buying it for like 3,500, for example. I just miss being able to bargain things and just buy things like that. I know this one is a bit of a controversy simply because it's about where you live. But where I live, one thing that I miss so much about living in Nigeria compared to where I live right now is transportation, okay? We live in a small town in Vicenza, Italy, and transportation here is so hard. Aside buses, nothing else is like very out there. Taxis are freaking expensive, okay? If you live in the bigger cities like Milan, Rome, you can access like the trains, maybe Uber, but in Italy, generally, Ubers are not very popular, okay? In Nigeria, we have Uber, we have Taxify, we have regular taxis, we have buses, we have Keke, we have Okada. We just have too many modes of transportation in Nigeria, and then you can own your own car. Here, a lot of people are stuck, okay? If you guys have one car, one person has to wait for one person to drive and come back home before you can do, or you have to tag along with other people. It's just too much. So that's something else I miss about Nigeria. The transportation is just way easier in Nigeria. There's just too many modes of transportation compared to here. The next one is like that community, that sense of oneness, that culture. I don't know how to explain it, but in Nigeria, right, let me just make an example with the estate that I used to live in, Godap Estate in Lifeka. When I used to go to work, like when I'm going out, all these like security guards, they'll be like,
"Can't see me, like, how far you day, you fine, just you fine, you know, you need dress, you bust my head."
Like all the security guards, they'll just be hyping you, they'll be making you feel like you're a big deal, all of that. I know most of them, they do it so that you can give them little something, you know, but like I was always excited to do that, because like when you genuinely dress nice, they will tell you like you look good, your hair looks beautiful, they will hail you. I miss that part of Nigeria where, you know, people just have that sense of community. People just have that sense of oneness, and everybody's just, you know, all over. Just here is mind your business thing. Like me and my neighbor, we can be upstairs and downstairs for like a month and we will not see each other. Maybe we can once in a while talk on the phone when we live together right up there. If it's Nigeria, well, somebody will just wear their shorts and just come to your house and knock your door and be like, "Alpha, I've not seen you in a while. You know, like, what's wrong? Are you all right?" You know, but that sense of oneness is not really like that out here. Here is everybody mind your business, go to your work and back. Everybody's too civil. Everybody's just, you know, it's just like, "Hey, I'm a big woman on my own. You're a big man on your own. Just do your thing and I do my own." I like my privacy a lot, and I won't tell you that I don't enjoy like my life here right now, because I absolutely do. Like, I'm one person that enjoy the comfort of myself, okay, the comfort of my home. I like staying on my own and just being on my own. So this whole not being checked upon and all of that don't bother me, because I like my space. I just like it to give me my space, okay? So I'm not even worried about that, but I'm just saying that I do miss that community, that culture, just that oneness, that sense of oneness of people just checking up on you randomly, knocking on your door and just wanting to know what's up, and just, you know, people that work for you just, you know, make you feel some kind of special way. Like, I like that spirit about Nigeria. What else do I miss about living in Nigeria? Let me see, what else do I miss? Of course I miss my family. Like, I just miss that at the back of my head, I know that even though I live in another state and my family live in another state, it's just going to take me maybe like 25,000 naira to book a flight and go to where they are, or it will take me like 6,000 naira to take a bus to where they are. But here, you know that your family is not here, like they're not that close. So if for anything, you're going to have to spend $1,000 plus to book flights to go back home and back. You know, I just miss that sense of, oh, even though we're not really together, you're not that far away feeling, compared to being here and knowing that nobody, absolutely no family member is close by, which is one of the reasons why I'm so scared of doing some things. It's like, if I come and do this thing now, I don't have any family here to come and assist me, you know, like I will be all alone and I'll be suffering. So sometimes there are a lot of things that we want to do, but I don't want to do them because we're just all alone here. And sometimes it's just so hard when you don't have any help at all. So that's one thing that I miss about living in Nigeria. After you finish watching this video, go to Dr. Zidam's vlogs channel and show her some love, you guys, please. And when you're there, tell her you're from Tonya, you know, Tonya, because you guys rock with me like that. Go to her YouTube channel, subscribe to her YouTube channel, watch her videos, like them, and I know you're going to like her because she likes traveling just like me. And if you're one person that likes food, she can cook, okay? So you guys, if you live abroad, away from your country of origin, and there's anything at all that you miss about where you come from, do let me know in the comment section and I'll be sure to reply you, because I always do. So yes, that's the end of this video, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to smash the subscribe button if you're new on here, and break it, okay? Destroy it. Just do whatever you like already, okay? Just make sure that that red subscribe thing turns into gray, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, and then click on the notification bell.